So my name's Sarah Haley, 22 years old. I double major in economics and political science. I run track and field. I'm a pole vaulter.
My name is Tanner Cousins. I'm a senior here at Banta University. I'm studying anthropology, and I'm on the men's lacrosse team. I'm a goalkeeper.
Hi, my name is Bridget Hunt. I'm 21. I play right field, and I'm a psychology major.
I tried it in ninth grade in high school. It was just kind of on a whim. We didn't really have any pole vaulters, so my coach, who was actually like a distance guy, was, you know, just like, let's just try it out and see what happens. And that was the first time I ever tried it.
First time I played lacrosse was when I was 6 years old. I picked up a stick. We bought a stick from the local shop, and I was terrible at it. And I think I was even playing with a girl stick. I'm not entirely sure. But then I actually switched to baseball, and I wasn't that thrilled by it, so I decided to go back to lacrosse, and it's stuck ever since. So.
So I was probably the one kid in the outfield that was always picking flowers and just like goofing off. And I remember like throwing balls at people, and I would always throw it like right at them. They're like, "Wow, how'd you do that?" I was like, "I don't know, I'm just throwing the ball." So I guess I always had like a natural talent towards softball.
So I was more on the business aspect of things when I was considering majors, and so I fell into economics, which has like a business aspect to it, like a worldly business aspect to it. So that's what made me stay with it, and then I took a couple of political science classes, and I really enjoyed the aspect of like opinion writing on politics and all these different kinds. So it's like these two majors that really just flowed well together, and that have really just, you know, reflected off of each other, which has made me like stay with both of them.
Well, when I came to Binghamton, I came here pretty much just to do the whole lacrosse bit, so I didn't really think too much about education. But after a few years of figuring out what I was good at and what I wasn't that great at, I decided that anthropology kind of fit me personally the best. And while I don't know how it's going to directly translate to post-graduation, it definitely is entirely relevant to me as a person, so I enjoyed learning about it.
Okay, so this is a long story. So I wanted to come in as a nursing major, but then I found out with softball that's really hard to do because you have to do clinicals. So I came in with an interest in bio, and then I took a chem class, and I was like, maybe this isn't right for me. So I ended up going with psychology with a goal of doing like an accelerated program after I graduate in nursing. And then my junior year, I kind of fell into the track of athletic training, and I started to get into that because I was in the training room so much, and I was like, wow, this is amazing. Like, this is what I want to do. So psychology definitely helped me lead the way into that. I don't think choosing Binghamton was a difficult decision at all. I think it just felt very natural. From the minute I heard about Binghamton, I wanted to come up here and see what the atmosphere and what campus life was like, and I think I fell in love with it the minute I saw it.
It was an interesting decision. Athletics, you know, maybe was a big part of that decision. Academics was another big part of that decision. A degree from Binghamton is pretty cool. My mind's just kind of honestly been blown by the whole experience, and it just keeps getting bigger, and they want to add a new campus and a couple more thousand students, and I think that's great, and I think people got the right direction here, and it's really exciting to be here and be a part of it.
So I had done a couple of recruiting trips at other schools, and then by the time I came to Binghamton, it was just that Binghamton, like the how the team was a family and how everyone like wanted me to be a part of everything, and it was just so down to earth compared to all the other schools I had went to. It just made you feel like you had a place here, and I ended up after that trip canceling all my other recruiting trips, and it's just like, yeah, Binghamton's where I'm going 100%.
All right, we are here live with Sarah Haley of Binghamton, the gold medalist in the women's pole vault with a final height of 3.70 meters. Sarah, it was back and forth with you in Vermont.
I really enjoy listening to music, different kinds, just anything just to find my own focus. I don't really like to talk to anyone when I'm getting ready, which can come off as a little like intimidating, which makes me feel good. And yeah, so it's basically as I just, you know, do my warm up and just listen to music, and I usually take like an hour to really focus in and get ready for whatever event I'm about to do. After, you know, 4 years of doing it with him in high school, it was a very challenging event, which I really liked about it, and I thought I could get better than I was in high school. So that was basically why I wanted to just keep trying. So on a practice aspect of it, I really enjoy it because I feel like I'm in better shape. So I do a lot of hard workouts throughout the week that I wouldn't do if I was just pole vaulting, which I really enjoy because then I feel like ready to go. And then, but when it comes to competition, it can be a little challenging. I have a difficult time with pole vaulting after I do a running event. So most of the time we'll try to set it up so I pole vault and then run if it's possible. So that's like the mainly challenging thing, but I really like doing both because I don't want to just pole vault and then be done at the meet. I like doing multiple things so I'm not just sitting around all day. I think especially when it comes to the conference meet, I'm a very, very competitive person, and I've always been a competitive person. So when it comes, you know, we go to meets every weekend, and a lot of times you're focusing on yourself, and you're focusing on like what you could do better in order to PR, and like what's gonna improve your score. You don't really think about the place as much. But when it comes to conferences, it's all about the place. It's all about, you know, getting first and to get the most points for your team, and just that meet being so competitive and all about points just like brings out like a different kind of like brings makes me like, I just compete differently. I'm just like ready to go and I'm ready. I just want to win. Like I just bring on the winning mentality and I just do whatever I can to do that. And I think that's what changes from like the season to that meet specifically. And I always just try to do my best to get there. So I played in high school, I played all the different types of team sports. And the one thing about track when I switched over to track was that, you know, it's a very individual sport because it's like the more work you put in, the better results that you're gonna see. But at the same time, it was the most team oriented sport that I've ever been in. So, you know, we come onto this team and like you show up to practice and you know, you have your teammates like cheering you on, you have your teammates like running your workouts with you, pushing you to that extra step, and then you also have them to lean on afterwards. So you just have the biggest support system and everyone wants you to do well. So I think overall the sports I've ever played on, I felt the most support on being on a track team.
If you like defense, this was the game for you.
And if you like goalkeeping, especially yes. What we saw in the second half with Tanner Cousins, he was extraordinary. Only one save at halftime. Didn't have a whole lot to do. Binghamton led 5-3, and then it was the Tanner Cousins show in the second half. The first team All-American East goalie with 8 second half saves.
It was a dangerous
play. Yes, definitely. I would say so. I would think that my uncle playing lacrosse definitely channeled my energy and my like passion to kind of, I wouldn't say fulfill anything necessarily, but just it was interesting to see, you know, within my family to see how he was respected and everything and how people really looked up to him. So it was definitely an inspiration for me.
Yeah.
Playing goalie, it started off with hockey, really. I played hockey when I was really little, and just watching on the TV with my dad, I just thought that the goalies were like the flashiest and the best, and they were saving, you know, everybody was clapping for him. So that's where like that passion really started. And then when, you know, like we were talking about my uncle playing at Syracuse and everything and being really successful with that, that really kind of just helped to kind of shape me and mold me to being into, you know, playing lacrosse and playing goalie and sticking with it and, you know, through the ups and the downs. And, but yeah, I'd say that starting off as a hockey goalie definitely fueled my like inner drive to stay with that defensive mindset and playing goalie and being between the pipes. I used to be really superstitious, and it was like so annoying. It was just so annoying, and I couldn't handle it anymore. So I decided that through my preparation, I'm going to handle my superstitions. So this is like really kind of crazy, I'm not going to lie. But basically, as long as I get in like my main stuff before like a game, like before one of our games this year, I didn't even have any lacrosse. Like I like to juggle before a game, so I was juggling with Nature Valley bars instead of lacrosse balls. But like I got my juggling in before the game, so I was happy about that. So yeah, I have some like things that I like to key in on before a game and make sure I do, but I try to just stay relaxed mostly. Growing up, my biggest struggle that I faced in my life was that I have Tourette's. I have Tourette's syndrome, which is like a neurological disorder. So growing up, that was something that really kind of affected me, and lacrosse was like an awesome outlet for that. And then I kind of honestly handled all that, like that big issue when I was younger. So coming to Binghamton, I guess the biggest thing that I really had for myself was just kind of figuring out how to make things happen on a bigger level here, just you know, coming out of high school and actually having a bigger, you know, like, you know, being, I mean, well, you know, being kind of like a big fish in a small pond, and then coming to Binghamton and there's 15,000 people. It's just, you gotta realize that there's more to it academically, athletically. So the biggest transition for me there was basically just that, and trying to figure out who I was here and how the old Tanner could come be the new Tanner and that type of thing. And I'm still figuring things out, so, and we're running out of time, but I'm still figuring things out, so. What life skills has this sport taught me? I would say, specifically with the situation here, just what we went through the last couple of years and how we're doing now, and just the transition that we've kind of had with our program and just the influx of new individuals. And I would say that being resilient and being optimistic are two like huge life skills that this specific involvement with this sport has really taught me. I would like to think that I brought a little bit of difference, that I was just a little bit weirder than other people, that I kind of pushed people out of their comfort zones occasionally more often than others. And in return, honestly, Bearcat Lacrosse did the same thing for me. I mean, it pushed me to limits that I never thought I would be going to.
Natural drive in me to play softball. It's just like nothing really brings out like that passion that softball does for me. So I think that's why I definitely chose to. It's always been like a dream of mine. I definitely think so. I took a sports psychology class, and I think I'm able to apply so much information that I learned from that onto the field, and I'm able to communicate that with my teammates as well. So I definitely think it's helpful. I would say so. I've definitely been working on my speed once I got here as a freshman, and my goal was to like be on the leaderboard in the locker room, and I finally did that my junior year last year, so I think definitely coach likes to take advantage of the speed that I've gained throughout the years. The most important skill to be successful in softball is to have a short memory. So you can't go back, you can't change anything, it's already done, you can't pout, and you just have to be in the moment, but you have to get over that and you have to overcome it, because the beautiful thing about softball is that there's always a next time, there's always another opportunity, so you have to be ready for that because it just comes so fast. I think we just kind of started it at practice one day. We just had like a big dancing circle. When we stretch, we do a dancing game that always gets us pumped up. So I think it just keeps us loose and it keeps us going. It's definitely something fun to do. My teammates just make it so fun. They make it fun to come to practice. They make it fun to compete in games. I think they're the ones that keep me going, and anything that I do is because of them. It's because I want to do it for them, and I know that's reciprocated back to me. It was definitely tough to deal with. Definitely a lot of nights where I went back discouraged because I wasn't doing as well in practice, but my teammates were always there for me, and I knew I could always look to them for any kind of information or encouragement to just help me out through that time. They were definitely the ones that kept me going and kept me motivated to just come through. There was one practice, I remember it being in the fall, that coach had come up to me and she told me, "You're doing great with your rehab. Like, we appreciate everything that you're doing right now, and we can feel that you want to get back on the field." And it's just nice to have that noticed, because I was working very hard, going to the athletic training room almost every day to do rehab, and it was nice to be noticed. I'm hoping that I gave tradition to Bearcat Athletics. I'm just hoping I'm able to pass down something that I brought in to the team, and they'll be able to keep passing that down and throughout the program. And I think Bearcat Athletics gave me a family, definitely. Just everyone here is so close-knit, and not even just with my own team, but with other teams. I have so many friends, and I know I'll continue those relationships after college.
Tonight about all of your career and your opportunity here and all the things that you were able to do at Binghamton University and all that you achieved. Thank you for representing us in this university with your class and your excellence. And to all our seniors out there, remember, you're a Bearcat for life.
I have four siblings, and I would just like to say thank you for all the support. And you know, my sister's always sending me really funny Snapchats to get me through my college career, and my parents were, you know, being there whenever I needed them, and I can't thank them enough.
All right, Mom, Dad, Rob, and Aiden, just wanted to say that thank you very much for just kind of all of it. Can I have a little bit of flashbacks right now? We're getting sentimental here. It's only March 20th, 2017. I'm not that old yet, right? Like, you're still driving me to practice at, you know, Griffin Park out in Endicott that doesn't even exist anymore, I don't think. Just thank you very much for believing in me, for putting up with me mostly, and for just being like the backbone for me. Mom, for when I was 5 years old, putting me back out on the ice when I wanted to come off. Just thanks for always being there, and thanks for supporting me, and in the future, I know you guys are going to do that, and it's going to be awesome, so thank you. I love you guys.
So to my parents, I want to say thank you. Thank you for sacrificing so much to give me the opportunities that you never had. Thank you for taking off all those weekends to go drive me to my softball tournaments. Thank you for always making sure I have new equipment to be the best that I can be, and just thank you for always supporting me to allow me to follow my dreams of being a Division I softball player.